Hello, in this video I will show you hair baking in the hair tool. So this is new feature added in the I think version 1.8 it will be. The new hair baking button will be added to the left tool panel. Before pressing this, save your scene because it will open new blend file. So any unsaved change will be lost. So after using this button, we have new scene loaded. In here we have few objects. The camera on top will be used for baking because it is way faster to use actually render from camera rather than built-in baking solutions. Plus on top of that, built-in bakers do not have some options that that will be required for hair baking. So we have the camera and we have also two hair strands. On the left it is particle hair system, you can see it in here. This is like manually combat hair with child particles interpolated, and on the right we have curves. So with the hair tool baking you can use both of them, curves or particle hairs. But particle hairs are usually way faster and more optimized. So if you have lots of hairs and you want fast render, fast bake, you would usually want to convert the curves to particle hairs. It is actually possible with the hair tool. You just select the plane you want the hair to be attached, you select the curves, select the plane, and use the particular hair from curves, and that's it. Now you have those curves converted to particular hairs. But for now I will undo this, and just to demonstrate I will have those curves not converted, because with hair tool it will work with both particular hair and curve. So now in this panel we have more options and buttons. I want to save this scene as a new scene because I do not want to override the default one. So I will save this as, and in my example I will use some tuple array folder and save this. Okay, so we have the output texture folder where the textures will be baked. In my example I will use the texture folder and just accept this. You can also select the resolution, half K in my example will be okay. You have the quality, like if your bake is quite noisy, especially under occlusion, then just increase this to high quality. You have also you can choose the PNG or TGI format for baking. So to preview how this will look, you just use the render button. And now on the right we will be rendering from the top camera, and this is how the bake will look like. To preview different bakes you just click those buttons. This is how ambient occlusion looks, diffuse pass, opacity, normal map, root map with radiation from roots to tips to add some variation along the length, random ID mask to have each strand to make the slightly different color. And tangent map, it is useful for game engines to make specular follow the direction of the tangent of the hair. And depth map, so the thing with depth map, it is using driver. So by default Blender is not allowing to run drivers unless you use in the preferences and file settings you use this auto run scripts. So with this button enabled, it should the driver should work automatically. But if you don't have this option enabled in the preferences, you can just press reload trusted, and now after that the depth map will no longer be black. But remember that pressing this button also reverts the scene, so if you have something just save. In my case I will just revert, render this again. And now when we use the depth map, You see the render is correct because the driver is now working. The driver is set to this rectangle box. The name of the box is hard to see, but it is depth driver, and the z position of this plane is driving the look of the depth pass. So making this lower makes all the strands more white, making it higher darkens the hair strands. I make this the hair strands kind of like go more to the top to show the depth slightly better, but usually you wouldn't want this to be like so high. Okay, so now we just want to bake, for example, few passes. Let's shift select opacity, normal map, and root map, for example, and bake. It should be quite fast, and I think that's it. It already baked. So when you shift click this folder icon, you will be moved to the output, the texture folder. So now we have all the bakes in here. So mostly, usually you would want to pack those textures for optimizing texture space. So instead of using completely new texture of opacity, you would want to move this opacity into alpha channel. So I added option for that. It is called composite channels. So when you use this, enable this button, and let's say increase slightly the texture resolution to half K, and bake again, and we are done. So now you would have to click this button. This will be new button in the node editor, and you will have node 3 created, named channel mixing. So it is hidden in here. And now you have this those nodes with input textures, and each of them have RGBA channels, and you can pack them into output texture. So we have four textures selected, so we have four nodes. Let's say I will also want to add, for example, ambient occlusion. So I will select just ambient occlusion, and with this composite channels enabled, bake again, and the ambient occlusion is usually the slowest, but okay, it's done. So the new output is created, the new input node is created, and it is here ambient occlusion in here. To pack them into output texture, we shift click shift 8 and select output texture from here, and the output texture has few parameters. So first is the output path. So I just use the same folder to which I baked my maps. For output name, I will use, for example, hair packed, and this will be the output name of the texture. PNG is okay. So to preview the textures, you can use UV image editor and select in here hair packed texture. Now it is empty because nothing is connected. So as soon as I connect, for example, hair roots to the red channel, we have this texture displayed. And if we preview the red channel, we see that the red channel is now filled with hair root map. So it is looking like on the same way as in the rendered viewport. So now we can put, for example, in the green channel, we can put the maybe depth mask. So now when we preview the green channel, we have depth map in here. Because alpha channel is set to zero, when we preview the texture with the alpha channel, we see just the checkboard. But as soon as I increase the alpha to 1, you now see that both of those channels are being used and displayed correctly. So for alpha channel I will use the opacity mask, so I plug this and we have now correctly displayed opacity from the texture. And let's say in the last channel, the blue channel, I will put ambient occlusion to make it maybe bigger. I will full screen, and now the blue channel will be ambient occlusion. So let's preview the textures. Blue is ambient occlusion. It's a bit noisy, but if you render this with high quality, you won't have the noise. And all of the channels are taken. So to save this texture, you just can press this checkbox icon. And now if we open the output folder, we have this hair packed PNG file created. So this way, instead of using like 5 textures or 4 textures, you can pack 4 texture channels into one output texture, yeah? And then you can put this into the game engine. Usually you can't do this usually on the normal map, because normal map is already using 3 channels, so usually there is no point in converting normal map. The same goes for the tangent map. In tangent map we are using red and green channels, I think, so in theory you could pack something into the blue and alpha channel of tangent map. Or you can just skip it. Like, I mean, you can combine this and do anything you want. Like, let's say I have the normal map on the left. I can put red to red, green to green, blue to blue, and in the alpha of the normal, I can use the opacity mask. Let's say, okay, if something is not refreshing, you can use the button in here of selection of input textures. I will fix this soon, but for now I would say it is working quite good. It is not like final version. I will improve this to make possible to invert channels and probably add more features. But the hair baking itself is now quite stable. I will just have to work a bit more on the nodes parts. I will also want to show you how you can create example textures. So one way would be to create hair geometry would be create plane, and from this plane add some subdivisions and use this as source for hair strands. So let's say we want some longer and some shorter. So on the top we mark top edges as sharp, and from those two planes we create particular curves with curves from grid surface. And we can increase the strands amount, play with the noise amount, with the noise frequency. Probably this is a bit overkill. Change the opacity. Change the length. Maybe make them shorter. So anyway, you can see that you can quite quickly create the output and the mesh, and then to assign correct material to those curves, you just click and refresh any of those passes, and automatically the correct material from the pass will be assigned to those curves. You can then manually tweak those curves if you want, or you can use maybe grease pencil. So let's say I create this plane, and on this plane I will paint some grease pencil strokes and then convert them to curves, and curves can be then curves on grease pencil. Yes, this will be okay, I think. And then you can render those curves and bake them into the texture, or convert them to particle hairs if you want, and then from those particle hairs, let's say we add this particle hairs to this plane. So we do something like this. We select those curves created from grease pencil, select the plane, and with Ctrl Shift H we have option particle hair from curves. Now we can delete the curves and particular hairs are created, and now you can do anything you want, like with the default particular hairs. You can comb them, move them, do whatever. Add the child particles, child settings in here, interpolated, play with the clamping noise and stuff, and automatically correct material will be applied to them. Okay, so I think that's everything about the options with the hair baking in the hair tool. Hope you find this useful, and see ya.